In this video, we're going to talk about Home Assistant, what it is, how it works, and why I love it. Now make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and today we're going to be looking at Home Assistant. We're going to look at what Home Assistant is, where it came from, the benefits, the drawbacks, and then I'm going to tell you why I decided to use Home Assistant as the soul of my smart home. Now, if you stick around until the end, I'm going to show you some really cool user interfaces that I've created, as well as somewhere that you can demo and get your hands on other people's. Remember, anything I mention will be listed in the description below if you want to check it out yourself. So, what is Home Assistant? Well, to answer that, we're going to need to look at smart tech. Now, if we're going to want a smart home, we're going to need some smart tech. So what do we get? Maybe a Philips Hue light bulb for the bedroom, an Echo Dot for the sitting room, a Neos camera for the front door, a smart plug for the study. But the list goes on. And it really does go on. We've got Logitech Harmony, we've got LG TV, we've got LG ThinkU, we've got Philips TV, we've got Philips Hue, we've got Tuyu, we've got Wyze, we've got Neos, Broadlink, we've got IHC, we've got Evo Home, we've got Nest, we've got Ring, we've got Google, we've got Amazon. You can see how before too long you could have up to 20 devices from 20 different companies, needing 20 different apps to control them. But we're trying to keep things simple. We want everything in one app, so we want our phone looking like this and not this. So what we're looking for is a single hub where you can control all our devices in one place. The two common options for this is Google Assistant or Amazon Echo. To do this, we need to make sure our kit is compatible. So generally, on the box, it'll say works with or works with. To set it up, you just need to follow the instructions, generally downloading a skill or an app, depending on the platform. Once this is done, you can create routines to let your devices interact with each other. So, you say, why not use one of these options? Well, there are three main reasons to avoid these hubs. Firstly, the list of devices that works with these two isn't exhaustive. That's not to say it isn't ever growing, but you're much more likely to find a device that works with Home Assistant than with Google or Amazon. That's because the Home Assistant community can find workarounds and custom components to let your devices interact with each other. Second, we're relying on other people. We're relying on the Amazon servers or the Google servers to control any of our devices. We're also relying on the servers of each brand. The TP-Link servers, the Philips Hue servers, the Honeywell servers, the Neos servers, the Wyze servers. If any of these go down, we're left without any access to our device. And that brings us on to our last point, security. Every time we get a new device, we're logging into a new cloud server, giving more people our data. The more devices we have, the more data we're giving away. We could be giving away where we are, whether we're at home, when we sleep, what music we listen to, even if the door is locked or unlocked. Now, I'm sure most of you will be fine, but if that's enough to make you concerned about using one of the big names as your hub, then look no further than Home Assistant. Home Assistant is an open source local hub which you can use instead of Google or Amazon to connect to all your devices. Home Assistant has over 1500 integrations. Most of these are different devices and different brands which work with Home Assistant. To use Home Assistant, connect the device to its app and then add the integration into your Home Assistant the same way that you would with other devices. You might think, hold on, if I'm still using their app, they can still collect data. And you'd be right. So to take this one step further, we want to remove their involvement entirely. Generally, to do this, we have to take the device apart so we can flash it with custom firmware such as Tasmota or ESP Home. Now, this is as secure as a smart home can get, keeping all the devices on your local network and only your local network. So now we can answer the main question. What is Home Assistant? Now, Home Assistant is a local server used as a hub to connect all your smart devices. You can use it alongside Google or Amazon, or replace them entirely. Most people start their Home Assistant running on a Raspberry Pi, but you can use any old computer you have lying around, or even run it inside a virtual machine. The founder of Home Assistant once said, "Good home automation never annoys, but is missed when it's not working." Now, the principle of Home Assistant is it should make your life easy, but it should also be easy for anyone else coming into your home. It should limit the impact of problems if things stop working, and it should be stored in the home and not in the cloud. Home Assistant is open source home automation that puts control and privacy first. It is constantly evolving and growing, and with an ever-increasing community, the features just keep coming. The benefits of Home Assistant are security. By having everything local, you're not exposing it to the World Wide Web. Integration. You can connect all sorts of well-known devices, including making your own. Automations. You can link all your devices together and create some really cool automations that make your life easier. And of course, it's a great project. Really fun to work on, and you'll never run out of things to try out. Now, automations is really where it's at. Why should we be doing anything ourselves in a smart home? Because you can link so much into Home Assistant, you can get so much out of it. You could get it to tell you what your shopping list is when you arrive at Tesco, or turn the heating off if nobody's home, or even let you know if you've left a door or window open while you're out. You can make automations as simple or as complicated as you like. I use Node-RED for my automations because it gives a very clear graphical interface, so it's easier to set them up and make sure they're working. Of course, it wouldn't be fair to talk about Home Assistant without mentioning some of the negatives. It's not as easy to set up as Google or Amazon equivalents, but once it is set up, it is so much more powerful. You're going to need to run your server at home, and this is obviously going to draw power, and you're going to need a Raspberry Pi or other machine to run it on. It can go wrong. Obviously, you have complete control over your setup, so if you make a mistake, you might lose control over your home. This is why it might be good to use Home Assistant to supplement your setup, at least while you're starting out until you've got some fail-safes in place. The big thing people complain about is ease of use. It requires a bit of technical knowledge to set it up, and if you don't invest the time in setting it up correctly and to what you want, then it won't be easy to use. Home Assistant is fully customizable, so you've got to make sure you're making the most out of what you want it to be able to do for you, and then it won't let you down. In spite of all this, I've decided to use Home Assistant for so many reasons. Mostly because it's constantly growing and evolving. I will never get bored of working on my Home Assistant setup. I was, however, fed up of having so many apps to control my so-called smart devices. But now with Home Assistant, I've linked everything together and I've turned my connected kit smart. So I said I'd show you some of my user interfaces, and here they are. This one is designed to be shown on a tablet in a communal area. Amongst other things, it gives me an overview of temperature in the house, the weather, and lets me know any events in my calendar. It also gives me a Wi-Fi access code if I have guests in the house. This is based on the code by Isabella Alstrom, linked below. Now, I've also been working on a floor plan layout. With this, you can see a visual representation of the current state of the house. When I click on the light, the room lights up. It also changes colour if I change the colour of the light. I got the code for this one from Luke Vink. If you're thinking about getting Home Assistant for yourself, but want to try it out, have a look at the demo feature on the Home Assistant website so you can get some hands-on experience with other people's user interfaces. Now, if you liked what you saw today, make sure you hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos about my tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.